Live triple header begins right now between the Hanover Indians and the Bishop Stang Spartans. It is a Division III South quarterfinal. Hanover the 3 seed, Bishop Stang the 22 seed. They've already upset 2 teams on their way to get here. To begin the game, Hanover will be going from right to left across the screen on offense. Bishop Stang from left to right. Hanover is in whites with gold and navy blue. Very reminiscent of the Buffalo Sabres. Bishop Stang in maroon. Starting in net for Hanover, Noah Clapp. For Bishop Stang, it's Ryan Hubert, who falls on the puck immediately off the draw. Draw coming up in the Hanover attacking zone. That was Landon Hassenfuss on the draw. Bishop Stang, 9-10-3 out of the Eastern Athletic Conference. Hanover, on the other hand, 15-3-2 out of the Patriot League Fisher Division. Play has been all Hanover here early. They have the much superior record in the regular season, of course. That's Noah Dorr. Trying to clean the puck out of his own end. Hanover maintained possession momentarily. Big hit. Down went Paul McCabe. It's a clean play. And McCabe goes down again at the hands of Brendan O'Neill. He's a one-man wrecking crew. Here's a steal for the Stangs. It is Ethan DeMoranville who was denied. Hanover back the other way. Dumping the puck in was Ernie Meads. Behind his own net, Mike Scarbeck. In the slot, Tommy Martin was setting up shot from the point. Shot was taken by McCabe, proving he can take a hit and get right back up and contribute, but it was blocked in front. Trevor Doucette. Send it towards the net, giving up his body was Mike Scarbeck again. In the near side corner boards, with already 2 minutes gone by in the first period. Hanover, it's McCabe. Cross ice for Mike McGlane. Shot taken from beyond the blue line, off the stick of Ernie Meads, and deflected over the end glass. We got another draw coming up in the Hanover attack it in. Landon Hassenfuss on the draw. Won it toward the half wall to Connor Morris. But the Stangs are there. Out of their own end, they try to come. From his own end, Christian Saruta gets it up to Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss gets taken off the play. But there to pick out the slack is Morris. To the near point for Saruta, sends it back to the corner. 12:03 to go in a scoreless first period. From beyond the far corner, Tucker Mendonca for Bishop Stang tries to control it. Here they come. Cade Kaminsky in, does not get the shot off, swept up by Saruta. Hanover in transition. It's Hassenfuss. Out of his net to tend it is Hubert. Very loud Bishop Stang contingent. Teams are about equidistant. Bishop Stang located in Taunton. Hanover, of course. And Hanover. Exit 13 off Route 3, the quickest way to get here. For Hanover. Bishop Stang can travel down 195. Hanover back. It's Ernie Meads. But it's intercepted by Bishop Stang in their own end. all the way down. This will tumble to the corner and be an ice. Touched by Tyler Powers. We're coming back in the Hanover attacking zone at 11:04 to go in the first period. I'm Jake Levin, by the way. Art Egerton on video. Two-man crew tonight. That was Doucette on the draw for the Indians. It's up against those end boards. Martin was looking for Meads in front, cleared out. Hanover fans traveled as well, but Bishop Stang has been louder early here. Not much question about 4.5 gone. That is shot and saved. Jack McCarthy on the shot. It went off the gloves, it looked like, of Shane Fallon. But Noah Clapp, right place at the right time. 10:40 to go in the first period. No score between the Spartans and the Indians. This will be Matt Trudault on the draw. Lost it. It's Connor Morris now for Hanover, trying to get it out of his own end. He gets puck back at the far half wall, advances it out, and connects with Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss got it for Wisness, but it's offside with 10:24 to go. Hanover got here by defeating the Diamond Bengals 10-2 in the first round of the D3 South. Bishop Stang, an underdog. They're the 22 seed. Knock off number 11 Sacred Heart 3-1 in the preliminaries. And upset old Rochester Fairhaven, that co-op, 4-2 in the first round. It's just one of those tournaments. The 22, and this puck is intercepted. It's shot, but saved by Clapp. That was Tristan Costa on the steal. Just over 5 minutes gone. I cannot get over how loud the Bishop Stang crowd is. I thought this building was pretty loud during the first game this afternoon. That was between Barnesville and Marshfield. We'll talk about that in a few moments. Doucette in, knocked off the play by Hunter Foley. Saved by Hubert. He sends it off to the end boards. Played by Noah Dorr. Dorr trying to work it out towards Costa. And Costa, a captain, will indeed carry it out. He is interfered with by Tommy Martin. And that should be an offside. 9:25 to go, still scoreless. Game 3 of MyHockeyLive.com triple header. As I was saying, one of those tournaments, Attleboro, the only seed lower than Bishop Stang in this tournament of 23 teams, is also still active. Play with no fear if you're seeded that low. Bishop Stang's already ruined two teams with better records seasons. Will Hanover fall victim? Or will they get a dream matchup, potentially with the Norwell Clippers, in the semifinals? The state semifinals, that is. It would be the D3 South Finals. Norwell and Hanover, they're in different leagues, but they are adjacent towns. Sort of a three-way rivalry between those three, and that includes the Rockland Bulldogs. Coogan lost the draw for the Stangs. Hanover back, Drew Craddy. Up for Ryan Mahoney. Mahoney gains the line up the right side. Mahoney towards Phillips, shot, and it's wide. The Stangs defensively. It's Kaminsky. Scarbeck. And now O'Neill trying to send it in. Hanover has had the better scoring chances, but I'd say Bishop Stang has outplayed them thus far. Hunter Foley sends it in on Clapp, who covers up for the save. It was on the rebound that Ethan DeMorinville attempted to crash. 8:21 to go, first period, still scoreless. We await the draw on the near side of the Hanover defensive end. Shot is taken and saved by Clapp. To Troll on the shot. Paul McCabe, who's on the receiving end, two big hits earlier, sends it along the perimeter, added into the neutral zone. Being taken down was Hassenfuss. Says with the play and dumps it into the corner, coming all the way out of his net to cover it up is Hubert. Well beyond the goal line. Winner of this game faces the winner of the Southeastern West Bridgewater Co-op in Attleboro. Likely on Friday night. Here's a chance for the Stangs. It's Costa. Costa in is able to connect all the way up and a save by Clapp. He had Kaminsky in the slot, but Clapp robs him. .747 to go in the first period. The goalies trading chances, outshining one another in the early going. Shane Fallon for Hanover. For Ernie Meads. Back towards Fallon along the inboards. He'll try to get the clear, but he's taken down by Mendonca. Nevertheless, up ice come the Indians. Diagonal pass for Tommy Martin. Thought he had the line gained, but a late offside is called. That'll get us to draw in the neutral zone. 7:24, still to go in the first. Bishop Stang from the Eastern Athletic Conference. Hanover from the Patriot League, Fisher Division. Draw is won cleanly by Doucette. Shot into the Hanover attacking zone. Hubert came out of his net to play it. Doucette. Along the far half wall, out of the point, it's Powers is going to tee it up. It was blocked off the stick of McCarthy and cleared out. Right back to Powers, who sends it on Hubert. Glove save, just knocked it down. Came loose to Brian Allen. From his own end, it's Doerr. Bishop Stang all of a sudden having trouble creating chances, getting it out of their own end. Again, it's swept at it back in by Doucette. Would have been an offside. A saucer pass from Foley was intended up ice for O'Neill. Knocked away. 6.5 to go in the scoreless first period. Here's Shane Fallon. Fallon with some moves, some stick handling and some meeks. Gains the line. It is popped well over the goal of Hubert. Falls harmlessly behind him on the end boards. In the corner, swept at by Joe St. Martin. Tyler Powers tried to connect on a home run pass for Costa. That is going to be an icing. 6:05 to go. Are you thinking about buying or selling your home this year and not sure where to start? Do you know what your property is worth? Kristen Daly and her team have been helping people purchase and sell homes for over 10 years, and they can help you figure out the answers to all these questions. Kristen and her team would be more than happy to help you figure out the right move for you. Help you navigate the process and get you into the home that you've been looking for. Don't find yourself in the penalty box using the wrong agent. You can call Kristen directly. 781-264-6457. Another huge hit. It was Connor Morris this time. McCabe was not on the receiving end. Bishop Stang gains the line, knocked out by Hanover. Anyways, you can also find her at www.kristendailyire.com. She looks forward to working with you. Contact Kristen in the next 24 hours, and she will provide a one-hour staging consultant with her interior designer. Just about down to 5 minutes to go in the first. The Norwell team exits the building. Fresh off a 6-0 victory over the Bourne Canalmen. That was Grady Dole waving at the camera for Norwell. He's pumped up. His team's moving on. Mike McGlame bagging a lead for Tommy Martin. Tommy Martin dumps it into the near corner. He'll try to chase it down. Door the first one there for the Stangs. Hunter Foley trying to get a clear inside 5 minutes to go, about 4.5, as a matter of fact. This is Foley. Dumps it in off the end boards. Be a battle along that end wall. Martin knocked out of play. We got a scrum in the corner boards. Still no penalties in this first period. McCabe working it up for Tommy Martin. Still scoreless. Hanover, the 3 seed. Bishop Stang, the 22 seed. Bishop Stang not afraid of higher seeded teams, although Hanover is their toughest test yet. In line, Alex O'Dowd gives chase. That's Daniel McDougal trying to fire it and went wide. Far point, the left shot came from Drew Cattery and it was blocked. Here's Bishop Stang up ice. Kaminsky knocked off the play. And McGuire assumes control of the puck for the Indians with 3:36 to go. McDougal tried to get the clear and it was shot from the point by St. Martin. Blocked before it could reach the goal. This is McGuire up ice for the Indians. Batted in by Ceruta. Nobody there for Hanover. They were changing lines. Scarbeck in his own end. Goes back over to St. Martin. Here's Corey Arden. Arden sends it wide of the post to the far side. As we were ticking inside 3 minutes ago now, 2:55 in the first period. Landon Hassenfuss, one of the co-captains. Alex Wisnes now. Wisnes fires, saved by Hubert. Shot taken by Fallon, well wide. Picking up the rebound, Hassenfuss tried anyways, staying up the other way. Off the sideboards, O'Neill tried to gain entry to the line. McCarthy there to pick up the loose puck. 2:24 to go. Shane Fallon from deep in his own end. Up ice to Alex Wisnes. Tries to get to Martin. And Martin gains control, or at least gains the line, but not the puck. He is taken down. A big hit by Hunter Foley. He was a little slow to wince out of it, but he's okay. Thought he was going to get a call. Fallon sends it off his own man into his attacking zone, but nobody was there. Inside 2 minutes to go now. Up ice is Foley. This is Fallon, connected with Martin, who sent it to Doucette and dumps it into the corner, playing the carom to the end boards, where he is met by Dorr. Allen sent it across ice, and now all the way up here comes Bishop Stang with a chance. It is Mendonca, but he was denied. 1:26 to go. Very aggressive on the forecheck. Now is Doucette. Hassenfuss was backing him up. Offside, delayed offside against Hanover. Enabling Stang another chance. It is Kaminsky. Kaminsky to slot, no look, backhand pass, batted in from the point now by Scarbeck. But well wide into the corner boards with a minute to play. Glove down by Hubert. Back in his own end, 57 seconds to go. We're going to get a draw. Game also brought to you in part by Jif Dippers to Go. New Jif to Go Dippers combine creamy Jif peanut butter and crunchy pretzels for the perfect grab-and-go snack. Hassenfuss on the draw. Went it back to the point for McGlane. McGlane back to Hassenfuss, intercepted by McCarthy. Lowe trying to backhand it and save Hubert. That was from Morris. Keep it alive at the point as McCabe was going to tee it up. Deflected by Hassenfuss. Goes wide. to the end boards. Goal is well off its moorings, and we finally get a whistle with 32 seconds to go in the first. It is a loud Bishop Stang's crowd, no question. Louder than Hanover so far, although maybe that's because I'm right in front of them. Scoreless game with 29 seconds to go. Up ice comes Kaminsky, advance it to Costa. Costa tried to get the shot off. It was blocked in part by McCabe, and it goes to the end boards where the first one there is McGlain. In the slot shot, and it went off the post. Absolutely denied there by the post was Mendonca. 7 seconds to go. Hanover dodged a bullet, and they know it. They will be content going to the locker room with this scoreless tie. That will do it for the first period. A scoreless first period between the Bishop Stang Spartans and the Hanover Indians. Transitions Kitchens and Baths is conveniently located on Washington Street in Norwell. The home is an extension of the family. No one understands this better than Transitions. Your kitchen, bathroom, laundry room, and even the closets reflect your family's needs. But just as importantly, they should reflect your family's personality. In our showroom, you'll find an amazing array of the latest fashions and trends in the kitchen and bath industry. At Transitions, you'll receive one-on-one consultation in our showroom or at your home. Transitions is focused on providing the expertise to fulfill your project's needs from concept to completion. It's the kind of customer service that sets Transitions apart. Visit us at www.transitionskbr.com. Transitions, Kitchens, and Baths, embracing style, personality, and home. That'll do it for the first period. Scoreless between Hanover and Bishop Stang. We will take a break. Don't go anywhere at MyHockeyLive.com. Bishop Stang Spartans, a scoreless first period, has resulted in both teams with some great scoring chances, as here's one from Powers, saved by Hubert. The whistle has blown. And ultimately it will be no goal. The net was dislodged from its moorings. I'm Jake Levin alongside Art Egerton on video. Second period of the third game of MyHockeyLive.com triple header. Shot taken this time by Martin, and it was blocked before it could get there. Here comes Sparty. It's Kaminsky, but well defended. Selling out was Tyler Powers. Powers knocks it off the half boards up for Ernie Meads. Powers again clears it. Sparty again, Kaminsky. A feed from Jack Martin. He couldn't get it to him cleanly. Hanover out of the Patriot League Fisher Division. Bishop Stang out of the Eastern Athletic Conference. Up ice is Ernie Meads. Dumps it, or tries to dump it in, but he is well defended. Here comes Sparty. Corey Arden. Big collision with Shane Fallon. Still in the Spartans attacking zone, it's Jack McCarthy along the end boards. Powers was the first one there. Shot into the far corner boards. Shane Fallon back there for Hanover. Intercepted at the blue line by Noah Dorr. Once again, Hanover will try to regroup. It is Trevor Doucette. Up ice, that was fired off the end glass by Tommy Martin. Still in the Hanover attacking zone. Spartans looking for a clear, and they get it. It is Jack McCarthy up ice, blocked by Connor Moritz. And behind his own net, Mike McGlain up for Landon Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss back towards Morris. It's Sparty puck right along the near boards. Hassenfuss with some stick handling, gains the line over the middle, thinks about shooting. It was well defended by Hunter Foley and taken down into the corner boards. He sent it towards the slot. Nobody was home. Mike McGlain. Back from McCabe, intercepted, although half-heartedly by McCarthy. Didn't do anything with it. He had room in front of him. Here's Connor Morris. Sends it from just beyond the blue line on to Hubert. Easy save. Sparty in transition. Intercepted by McGlain. That's going to be an offside. The official well on top of that one. 12:14 to go in the second period. Said it before, I'll say it again. Bishop Stang, sub-500 record in the regular season, second lowest seed in this tournament. Hasn't mattered for them so far. They've already upset two higher-seeded teams. But again, Hanover would be by far the toughest test to date. They are the 3 seed, Stang the 22. Teams have switched sides. Bishop Stang going from right to left. Hanover from left to right across your screen. Stang out of their own end, it's Mendonca. Went under the stick of McCabe, but a good positional save by Clapp, just in case, with 11:52 to go. Draw to come, and the Hanover defensive end on the far side of the ice. Controlled by the Spartans. Shot was taken. It was hummed over the glove of Kaminsky. Or taken by Kaminsky, I should say. Over the glove of Clapp, but well wide. Hanover trying to clear up. They catch a break. Ryan Mahoney. Mahoney into the backhand. Saved by Hubert. Not sure if the net came off its moorings there. I believe that is the case. Seemed like an odd whistle. But that explains it. About 4.5 gone in the second period. Still no score. We've seen it all today. We saw a double overtime thriller between Barnstable and Marshfield in the D1 South. Barnstable winning 5-4 on Matt Caskey's goal in double OT. Here's the shot for Hanover and an easy save for Hubert. We saw a blowout. Norwell over Bourne 6-0. A game that was never really in question for the Clippers, despite a scoreless first period. Jackal Cass, the goalie. He still played out of his mind for the Canal men, even though he gave up 6 goals. Could have been a lot worse. Shot is turned around and fired from Meads. Goes off the end boards in the slot. Meads was in the wrong position to shoot. To Craddy for Hanover. But now it's picked up by McCarthy. Martin. Long diagonal up for Doucette. Doucette goes down, a huge hit. At the hands of Tritault. Saucer pass to Tommy Martin. Has it poked away by Arden. Here comes Bishop Stang. Brandon O'Neill is just going to dump it in. The Stang will take a line change. Back the other way, Drew Craddy to Doucette. Poked away, Martin there for safety. But Bishop Stang again gets a clear. A Hanover fans trying to make themselves heard. I got to give it to Bishop Stang. They've been louder, at least so far. Haven't heard either side explode yet. There hasn't been a goal. Hanover in their own end. And St. Martin. Coming into the slot, batting at it, saved by Hubert. That was Alex Wisnes trying to backhand the puck home. 3-on-1 emerging for Bishop Stang, up ice, it's Dorr. Dorr tried to connect with Martin, couldn't get it to him cleanly. And the Hanover defense now back to react. That was the best chance for the Stang so far. But Martin's uncovered in the slot, and Tritault along the corner boards was held. Could not get it to him. The other way. It's Wisnes for Hanover. Wisnes gains the line. Went underneath the stick of Starbeck. But could not get the puck back. Again in transition, it's Bishop Stang. They've had cleaner breakouts. Staying with it. They just seem to be the hungrier team right now. fired, and a nice glove save by Noah Clapp. It is loud at Gallo Arena, as it's been all afternoon. Scoreless tie, 9-10 to go in the second period. We near the halfway point. That was Art. Couldn't get a shot off. Hanover the other way, 3-on-2, they come. That is Mahoney leading the charge. Mahoney went into the corner, and the odd man rush was over, but Hanover stays with it until it's picked up by Kaminsky. Back out of the neutral zone, Tommy Martin. Knocked down by Mendonca. Here comes Kaminsky. But he's forced off the play by Tyler Powers. Good play by the senior forward. That'll be an icing with 8:30 to go. It's coming back to the Bishop Stang attacking zone. Hanover wins the draw thanks to Trevor Doucette. Hanover gets the breakout. Doucette to Martin. Martin will give chase. Sent out of the zone by Foley. McGlame up the left side. It's tangled up with O'Neill. And here's Hanover. It's Meads. Fires. And it's up off the protective netting. We'll get a whistle and a face-off in the Hanover attacking zone, 8:02 to go in the second period. Hanover was 6-0-2 against Patriot League Fisher Division competition this year. Stangs win the draw. Mike Martino, check that, Hunter Foley. That's an ice. Again, we'll get a draw on the Hanover attacking end. Shots about even, chances about even. Somebody's getting tossed from the draw. It was Jack McCarthy, replaced by O'Neill, who wins it for Bishop Stang. But it's clear down the river for an ice. Yet again, a draw on the Hanover zone. Still on that far side of the ice in the left circle. There are 7 minutes and 49 seconds remaining in the second period. Set on the draw for the Indians, opposed by McCarthy. McCarthy wins it. Bishop Stang with another defensive end win on the draw. Trying to clear it, went off his own man. And there's Doucette. Doucette in, shot, and it was saved by Hubert. I thought it went over his glove. It may have, but still went wide of the net. Rebound goes loose to the corner. It's Meads. Meads still with it. Sent it towards Doucette in the slot. Swept away by Bishop Stang. O'Neill has a stick lifted by Meads. That's Tommy Martin in center ice. Shoots it right on Hubert, but he covers up for a save with 7:09 to go in the second. Bishop Stang will take a full line change. For another draw on their own end, Hanover's had a bunch of them these past few minutes. Hassenfuss will take the draw for the Indians. And wins it, advances it further to himself as he skates into the corner. We'll go on a tour of the attacking zone in the slot. One time bid for Wisniss, who was a bit too sharp. Still no penalties in this game of note as we're over halfway through. Wisniss up for Morris. Morris in the right circle, fires, glove save, Hubert. Hanover has taken over. They're getting all the draws in their attacking zone as both teams take a full line change. This one will come on the near side of their attacking end with 6:45 to go. Now Ryan Hubert, the senior goaltender for the Spartans, continues to play well. That shot was teed up by Powers, but blocked with the stick of Mendonca. Goes behind the net there. Losing an edge, Hanover with control of the puck. But Bishop Stang gets it right back, turning on the brakes. That was Skarbek. Out of his own end, up for Mendonca. Mendonca's going to gain the line, but it's taken down by Powers with a big how-do-you-do. Near corner, 6:17 to go. Here's Hanover in transition. They got a chance for an odd man rush. But well defended right at the blue line by Tristan Costa. But here's Powers. Powers is going to fire, and a save by Hubert. Yet again, a draw to come in the Hanover attacking end. You'd think eventually something's got to give, but Hubert continues to play extremely well. Near point, sent in for the turnaround, and that was Morris, whose shot was deflected wide. At the doorstep, taking the shot, another save, Hubert. Backhand bit, Hubert again holds his ground. That was Hassenfuss trying to bang it home on the backhand. Delayed offside, called against Hanover. Going in by himself, that was O'Neill, shoots it in. First one there is going to be McCabe. First time Bishop Stang's had some attacking zone time in a while. And they'll have a chance to continue it with a draw in their own end, or their attacking end. 5:32 to go in the second period. It is still scoreless between the Indians and the Spartans. McCarthy on the draw against Doucette. McCarthy wins and tried to shoot it, but it was blocked. Kept alive at the point by Dorr. Dorr sends it into the near corner, hoping one of his forwards can track down the puck, but Doucette is there for the Indians. Doucette up for Martin. Martin continues with the puck, is taken off the play. Doucette tries to advance it and does. And the slot shot, score! Doucette to Ernie Mees, a one-time bid. He was uncovered in the slot, and Hanover strikes first with 5:08 to go in the second period. It was going to take a defensive lapse like that to beat Ryan Hubert. There was simply nothing he could do. Ernie Meads was by himself. Excellent job, continuing play by Doucette. Here's Bishop Stang. Shot taken by DeMorinville, but an easy glove save for Noah Clapp. Goal comes at 9:52 of the second period. Going to get a draw in the Bishop Stang attacking zone. One by Mahoney. The other way. Hanover comes. Trying to set up Schaub yet again. We're inside. 5 minutes to go now in the second. Shooting up the left wing. That was Tretalt. Progress impeded, but the puck is still where he wants it to be in his attacking zone. But now Hanover, Shane Fallon with the puck. Up ice slightly. Stang trying to set up another chance. Chipped in and well defended by Powers, one of your co-captains for Hanover, who gloves down the puck and carries it up the right side. Gains the line, poked away. Here's Bishop Stang up the left wing. This is Mendonca. Mendonca from the backhand. Sent it wide of the goal. Clapp decided to fall on it rather than take any chances. 3:58 to go in the second. Hanover has taken the lead 1-0. Hanover a power in the Patriot League. Bishop staying in, but well defended. That's Mike McGlain, but we are going to get our first penalty of the game, and it's going to be against the Hanover Indians. What I was about to say about Hanover is that they defeated Division One at Duxbury Dragons back on January 24th, 5-2 at Duxbury. That game was at the Bog in Kingston. They could play with anyone. So seemingly they wouldn't be afraid of a sub-500 team like a Bishop Stang. But here are the Spartans giving the Indians all they can handle, and they now have a power play to reward themselves. Stang in their attacking end. About 10 seconds gone on the man advantage. That is Scarback. Now it's Mendonca, plays puck in the corner. And it got under the stick of St. Martin. Hassenfuss trying to give chase for a shorthanded opportunity. Wisness toes the line, had to wait for Hassenfuss to get back on side. Huge hit behind the play, behind the goal. Did not matter. Stang having trouble establishing the attacking zone. Here they go with Scarbeck, but offside. 41 seconds remaining on the man advantage. 2:53 to go in the second period. Draws won by Doucette and the Indians and popped up on a clearing attempt. Gloved down by O'Neill. Teeing that one up and clearing it all the way out was Shane Fallon. Got through some netting and wound up by some vending machines in the near corner. Half a minute to go on the man advantage for Hanover. And a penalty kill for Hanover. Bishop staying on the man advantage there, yet to generate a shot on this power play. It's Connor Morris in the box. He's a freshman forward. Here comes Stang. It's Scarbeck. Far half wall, battling with Doucette. Doucette gets the puck. Can't clear. Here's Kaminsky. Kaminsky fires, and a save by Clapp. The two goaltenders are shining in this one. So far, Clapp has been just a little bit better than Hubert. Picking nits at this point, though. Doucette wins the draw. Fallon will try to clear. Cannot do so. Kaminsky keeps alive with the skates. Mendonca from the circle fires. Blocked by Fallon. Mendonca stays with in the corners. He battles with Fallon. 7 seconds to go on the Stang power play. It's Mendonca in the far corner. Doucette pins him up against the boards. It's freed out to Kaminsky. From the right circle, Kaminsky shoots and up over the end glass. Shane Fallon got in front of the puck. That will do it for the power play. 5-on-5 hockey resumes. .207 to go in the second period. Shane Fallon, from behind his own net, is controlled in the center of the ice. Inside 2 minutes to go. Now it's Arden. Dumps it in off the end boards. Nobody there for Bishop Stang. Fallon will try to lead a charge back up ice. Connects with Morris. Morris in the right circle. Trailing pass for Taylor. It's off the end boards. Now is Morris trying to stay with it. Bishop Stang with a chance. Fired on that. Stick save by Clapp. Aimed by himself there was Brendan O'Neill. About 80 seconds remaining in the second period. That shot is well wide to the near side of the post, went off the end boards. Hanover will try to clear. Taylor up ice. Under the stick of foul, and nobody there for the Spartans to pick up the loose puck. Corralled by Hassenfuss. It's actually Powers. All the way down to Clapp in a positional save. Right place at the right time. Chipped at by Mendonca. Hanover gets it out of their own end. They look a little lackadaisical right now, do the Indians. Fired wide by Costa. Picking out the puck or trying to in the corner was Martin. Teen that up and another nice glove save by Noah Clapp. He's been the best player on the ice tonight. Slightly ahead of Ryan Hubert by a difference of only one goal. 42 seconds to go, second period. Draw coming in the Bishop Stang attacking zone. Draw is won handily by Hassenfuss. On the end boards, it was picked up by a second by Kaminsky. Shot was taken by Mendonca, blocked by Hassenfuss, and here's a chance for the Indians. Up ice, Hassenfuss trying to force it to Morris. Morris has an angle from the right circle. It was, again, well defended by Skarbek. Hanover still with the puck. Hassenfuss behind the net. 20 seconds go to the far corner boards. Hassenfuss on a tour of the attacking zone. Had his stick lifted. It is going to go all the way back to Clapp. Will come out of his net to play. 9 seconds to go. Hanover's got to hurry. This is Doucette. Doucette trailing pass for Martin. Martin for the right circle. Backhand shot. Went wide. And that's it for the second period of play. Yet again, a great period. This time only one goal. It was the Hanover Indians. Ernie Meads on the receiving end of a Trevor Doucette one-timer. Thanks to some of our sponsors here. Christian Daily Real Estate. Are you thinking about buying or selling your home this year and not sure where to start? Do you know what your property is worth? Kristen Daly and her team have been helping people purchase and sell homes for over 10 years, and they can help you answer all these questions. Kristen and her team would be more than happy to help figure out the right move for you, help you navigate the process, and get you into the home that you've been looking for. Don't find yourself at the penalty box using the wrong agent. You can call Kristen directly at 781-264-6457. You can also find her at Kristen Daly, R-E. com. She looks forward to working with you. Contact Kristen in the next 24 hours and she will provide a free 1 hour staging consult with her interior designer. And also by Transitions Kitchens and Baths, conveniently located on Washington Street in Norwell. The home is an extension of the family. No one understands this better than Transitions. Your kitchen, bathroom, laundry room, and even closets reflect your family's needs. But just as importantly, they should reflect your family's personality. In our showroom, you'll find an amazing array of the latest fashions and trends in the kitchen and bath industry. At Transitions, you receive one-on-one consultation in our showroom or at your home. Transitions is focused on providing the expertise to fulfill your project's needs from concept to completion. It's this kind of customer service that sets Transitions apart. Visit us at transitionskbr.com. Transitions, Kitchens and Baths, embracing style, personality, and home. Also by Integrated Benefits Group. Integrated Benefits Group is a boutique firm specializing in employee benefit and human capital management. Employee benefits are among the largest concerns for any company. IBG can manage costs that offer the right plans for your employees. In a changing marketplace, you need an expert, and Team IBG has been just that. For over 20 years, plan offerings include, but are limited to, medical, dental, vision, life insurance, disability benefits, voluntary benefits, retirement planning, and many more. If you got your no-cost benefits audit, please call Tony Matthew, 781-953-2000, or visit them online at www.thinkibg.com. And my Jif To-Go Dippers. New Jif To-Go Dippers. Come on, creamy Jif peanut butter and crunchy pretzels for the perfect grab-and-go snack. And by Mohawk Rubber. Mohawk Rubber Sales is the largest independent distributor of auto shop supplies in the USA and is headquartered right here in Mass. Mohawk carries only the most reputable brands in the industry and guaranteed delivery to most U.S. locations in under 3 days. Most of their products are available for purchase online, so be sure to check out their store at mohawkrubber.com. All right, we will take a break. Hanover 1, Bishop Stang 0, end of second period. Jake Levin alongside Art Eckerton. We'll be back. MyHockeyLive.com. Back for the third and final period of the third and final game of this MyHockeyLive.com triple header between the Hanover Indians and the Bishop Stang Spartans. Hanover with a 1-0 lead. The lone goal of the game scored by Ernie Meads on a feed from Trevor Doucette at 9:52 of the second period. The two goaltenders are playing out of their minds. No clap for Hanover. Ryan Hubert for Bishop Stang. The teams have switched sides one more time. Hanover going from right to left. There's another pad save by Hubert from Martin. And Bishop Stang moving from left to right. Bishop Stang in their maroon uniforms. Hanover in their whites with gold and navy blue trim. Draw comes back at center ice, less than a minute elapsed in the period. Behind his own net, Jack McCarthy carries the puck out for Bishop Stang for Brendan O'Neill. Brendan O'Neill up the right wing, sends it further for McCarthy. Out of the far point, Dora's gonna wrist it, and it goes in! One minute, 17 seconds into the period. Noah Dorr tees it up from just inside the blue line, and it was clearly deflected on its way in. We will see who gets the goal. It may be Hunter Foley, but it was all possible thanks to Noah Dorr just wristing it in. It is a 1-1 hockey game. Anything can happen from here. It will be Dora's goal. But here's Hanover the other way. Wisness turns around. Fired by McGlame into the corner. Hassenfuss for Wisness. We're going to get a penalty here. Looks like against Hassenfuss. Hanover starting to lose their cool a little bit. Chirping each other. The teams are. And route. Bishop Stang will go on the power play. Mendonca on the draw. He wins it. To the point for Skarbek. Back blocked in front. Joe was taken by Kaminsky. Still loose in front. Hanover will try to get it clear. And they do. And here's Wisness. Wisness shorthanded. Wisness fires. Save Hubert on the rebound. Nobody was there for Hanover. On the other way they come. It's Costa. Costa gains the line. It was a little out in front of Kaminsky. And Hanover gets another clear. About a minute left on the Bishop Stang power play. John St. Martin, too strong, and that'll be the Cardinal sin, icing on a power play. Jake Levin, Art Egerton on the video. Mark Eichel stopped by earlier. Phil Garceau helped out earlier today. Team effort as always on MyHockeyLive.com. Trevor Doucette, wins the draw, it's taken by Meads. That was your combination earlier. But a nice pad save by Ryan Hubert. Hubert, a senior goalie. Every game he's played this tournament has been potentially his last. Clearly, he does not want this to be his last. Draws one by Doucette, again back to Meads. Teed up wide by Fallon. Meant more to kill some time than an actual shot, but there's Doucette, who was aggressive on the forecheck. Foul from beyond the red line is going to send it over Hubert off the end glass, and jetting in is Doucette. He'll get the puck away from St. Martin, at least killing some time. Picked off by Meads. I think we have another penalty here. John St. Martin is going to go for a cross check. So it's 4-on-4 hockey for 27 seconds. For Hanover, we'll get an abbreviated power play. Hanover looked strong on their penalty kill. Can they continue? Doucette wins the draw to Powers, who will wrist it right into the glove of Ryan Hubert. Doucette again will take the draw against Jack McCarthy. Doucette wins it again. Doucette traces it into the corner. He gets there. There's Martin in the circle, fires. Save Hubert. Shorty just fell into him, and the play is blown dead, even though it went between the legs of Hubert. And Doucette is irate, but he'll lose his case. Hanover will get another attacking zone draw. With 15 seconds left on 4-on-4 hockey, Doucette again wins it, but where nobody was there, and Mendonca is able to clear it out for Bishop Stang. Powers in front of his own net, has to clear it out, gets it to Doucette. Penalty's expired against Hassenfuss. It's 5-on-4 for Hanover for about a minute. Nobody home for Hanover. That was Martin. Short-handed bit. The stretch pass all the way up to Mendonca, who goes crashing into the boards. He's right back up. Here's Tretol. Lops it into the far corner over everybody. 34 seconds to go on the power play for Hanover. It's Martin. Tommy Martin gains the line, centering for Hassenfuss. Deflected away right back to Martin in the corner, pass the outstretched Shane Fallon. Fallon will take it behind his own net with 16 seconds to go on the man advantage. Fallon backhand up for Doucette, shoots it in wide of Hubert. Stang will get the clear. It's Fallon at the red line. Connects with Martin as the penalty is set to expire. Martin gains the line, fires, and it's high over the end glass. We're going to get a draw at 10:45 to go in the third period of a tied game. This will be in the Hanover attacking zone. Mahoney wins the draw to the point for McCabe. McCabe sends it into the corner. Skarbek with the puck for Bishop Stang. Skarbek will try to take it out of his own end and gets into the neutral zone up the right side. Dumps it in. Both McCabe and McGlam going for the puck, trying to clear it out for Hanover. Far point. Hanover trying to get a clear. Bishop Stang keeping it alive. Still loose, McCabe in control, and finally got it out to Taylor. Advancing it further is McGlame. No sustained rush yet for Hanover. McGlame shoots it. Blocker saved by Hubert. 10 minutes even to go in the third period of a tied game. Division 3, South Sectional quarterfinal. That's an icing against Bishop Stang. Hanover get their attacking zone draw. 9:54 to go in the third. Pass and Fuss wins the draw. Shot taken and blocked by McLean. Pass and Fuss battling in the corner for the puck. He's winning the circle. Pass and Fuss fires. It is over the net. May have been wide anyways. Wisness sends it back into his attacking zone. Dorr, the goal scorer for Bishop Stang with the puck. Up for Mendonca. Trying to connect with Kaminsky. Off the sideboard as it was Allen. All the way back. Hanover trying to start another rush. Pass and Fuss sends down Dorr, but it's going to be offsides against the Indians with 9:08 still to go in the third. We've already had one overtime game today, a double overtime game between Barnstable and Marshfield. Barnstable won on Matt Caskey's third goal of the game in the second OT. Doucette to take the draw for the Indians, but lost it to McCarthy of the Spartans. About 9 minutes to go in regulation. Loose in the neutral zone. Misplayed by Powers, but foul in there to compensate. That's O'Neill in his end zone. Out to the point for St. Martin. Blocked in front and out of the reach of McCarthy for the one-time bid off the rebound. Still in the neutral zone. Bishop Stang will dump it in. Change the personnel. Shane Fallon back to collect the puck for Hanover. Up for Martin. Martin, a long pass, connects with Meads. He's your goal scorer for Hanover. Meads looking for Doucette. Blocked in part by DeMorinville. Neutral zone. Shane Fallon from beyond the blue line. Intentionally wide to the far side of the post. Doucette bats it in further. He'll concede possession to Bishop Stang. And up ice is DeMorinville. Gain the line, fires well wide, but a hard shot off the end boards. Down to 8 minutes to play. And that'll be an icing against Hanover. Bishop Stang will get a draw with an even 8 minutes to go in their attacking zone. The third and final game of the night on MyHockeyLive.com here at Gallo Arena in Bourne, just over the Sagamore Bridge. Wisness connects on an outlet pass with Morris, and scooping it up is Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss in, Hassenfuss shoots, save Hubert, held the near post, would have been hard for Hassenfuss to beat him. That is Morris. Turned it over. And a whistle. I think the net again came off its moorings. 7 minutes, 35 seconds to go. 1-1 the game. A trip to the Division III South semifinals awaits. The winner of this game will face the winner of the Southeastern West Bridgewater Co-op and Attleboro. Hassenfuss had his pocket picked by Mendonca, who gives it up ice for Costa. Kaminsky gave it to Dorr. Dorr from beyond the red line shoots it wide of Noah Clapp. We're down to 7 minutes to go. It's in the Bishop Stang attacking zone. A few Indians jump at the puck. Finally glove down. Here comes McCabe leading the charge. Save by Hubert. And he sends it over the end glass. A draw coming in the Hanover attacking end with 6:52 to go. It's going to be Mahoney on the draw for the Indians, opposed by McCarthy. And McCarthy wins it. Got it to St. Martin. But Mahoney battling for the puck along the end boards. Out to Arden. Corey Arden. Underneath the stick of O'Neill. And taken down by Shane Fallon. Off the side boards. It's Hanover. Morris. In front. Almost misplayed by St. Martin. But he's able to stay with it. And get it out of his zone up to O'Neill. O'Neill sends it in along the right side of the ice. Partial line change for Bishop Stang. 6:18 to go. Shane Fallon with the puck. Gets it up for Ryan Mahoney. Can't enter the zone cleanly. Sends it across the blue line towards Meats. Meats from the right circle. It's blocked. Shot taken, and it's off the end boards. Far point. Teed up by Powers and gloved down. Did not reach Hubert. 5:53 to go. Bishop Stang will take another line change. Here is Doucette, who will give chase with Hunter Foley in the corner boards. Underneath the stick of Meads, couldn't keep it alive for Hanover. Powers playing catch with Fallon. Fallon beyond the red line is going to tee it up over the crossbar by maybe 6 inches off the end boards. Dorr tried to start a rush. Dorr got it back. Advanced it for Costa. Costa with a Kaminsky, rather, and he was decapitated in front of the slot. Meade tries to lift it up towards Doucette, calmed by Foley. 5 minutes to go in the third period of a 1-1 hockey game. If they can't settle it in regulation, we'll play a 6-minute overtime. It's Kaminsky. Up ice, corralled by Powers. Powers collides with Kaminsky. Here's Hanover, it's Doucette. He's going to be by himself. Martin trailing him. Doucette fires well wide. But nonetheless, Hubert decides to kick it out of play just in case. 4:39 to go in the third. It'll be Hassenfuss on the draw, one of the Indians' co-captains, up against Jack McCarthy, and Hassenfuss wins it. Wizards tried to turn and fire, blocked. Hassenfuss did the same, again, blocked. Skarbek, trying to lead a rush out. Foley cleans up the mistake, up to O'Neill. Diagonal pass, intercepted by Morris. Morris to Hassenfuss, a bit inadvertent. Hassenfuss tangled up in the circle, but Morris is there for Hanover. Had some men out at the point, could not get there cleanly. It is O'Neill. O'Neill up the right side. O'Neill into the circle. Stick checked away by McCabe, who decides to take O'Neill out in the corner. In the slot, turn and fired, and a save made by Clapp. Hand over the other way. Line was gained by Martin, but sent right back out by McCabe. 3:45 to go. McGlame out of his own zone up to Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss up the right side, gained the line, battled and still battling with a Mendonca. Here's a chance for McCabe. McCabe is going to skate in atop the slot. He lets it rip. It's going to fall down in the corner. He'll follow his own shot where he bats it towards Martin. That's loose in the slot. Doucette was diving in, but it went off to the end boards anyhow. McCabe couldn't connect with Fallon. And the other way is Foley. Going to trickle beyond the net to the near side of Clapp. An attacking zone draw coming up for the Indians with 3:03 to go. Doucette wins the draw to Meads. It was blocked, kept alive at the point. Shot taken by Powers. Again, a glove save by Hubert. .258 to go. Doucette on the draw against Kaminsky. Doucette holds it. Shot is taken. It was over the crossbar off the stick of Martin. Stang will look for a clear. They can't get it, at least not yet. Kept alive by Meads, but now here they come. Up ice, it's Mendonca, but that's going to be offside. What a hockey game we have here. It's 1-1. Hanover, Bishop Stang. Division 3 South Sectional quarterfinals. Powers with a puck for the Indians and sends it in the neutral zone where Scarbeck is waiting for the Spartans. Shane Fallon for Hanover, long pass, trying to dial up Morris, but picked up by Scarbeck, who left it for St. Martin in his own end, and now further for Arden. Here comes O'Neill up the right. O'Neill with 2:12 to go moves into the near corner in his attacking zone. Big hit in the far corner. O'Neill still had a shot at the puck. Shane Fallon's going to pick it up. 2:02 to go. In the neutral zone, St. Martin sends it on Clapp, who gloves it down, but will let it free for Hanover to take a charge up ice with 1:50 left in regulation. It is Wisnes. Knocked down. And up the other way, Kaminsky for Mendonca, who fires it. Blocker saved by Clapp. That's Costa. Backhands it. Battle along the M boards between Mendonca and Powers. 1:28 to go. We're inside 90 seconds here. Wisnes collides with St. Martin. Hanover will try to get the puck out. Wisnes try to chip it over. Mendonca knocks it down and gains the line. Not much further advancement than that. 1:09 to go. All square at Gallo Arena. Here's Tommy Martin. Martin with Hasenfuss. Fires it and a stick save by Hubert. Hasenfuss along the M boards. Stolen away by Scarbeck. Cannot get a clear, however. Over the stick of Meade. And now here comes Arden. But he's taken off the play by Hasenfuss. Arden. Just in front of the Hanover bench. O'Neill moves in beyond Powers. 35 seconds to go. Hanover's going to have a charge here. Tommy Martin. But it was knocked free by Mendonca. Mendonca with a puck. Knocked free by Doucette. Right at center ice in the Canal Man logo. And St. Martin fired it on Clapp. And a save with 19 seconds to go in regulation. It will be a draw in the Bishop Stang attacking end. Game tied at 1. Bishop Stang wins the draw. That is St. Martin. Blocking the shot was Martin of Hanover. Here comes Doucette with 10 seconds to go. Doucette on ice with Meads in the middle. Doucette gains the line on the right side. Turns on the brakes in the right circle. Goes down. 3 seconds to go. We are going to overtime. It has been an absolute goaltender's duel between Ryan Hubert and Noah Clapp. If you've been watching My Hockey Live already today, you know the drill for overtime. Quick 1-minute break, and then 6 minutes of 5-on-5 overtime. If that does not yield a goal, it'll be 6 minutes of 4-on-4. That's where your Marshfield-Bartsville game ended. If that does not work, we'll go to a shootout. Good time to remind you, this game is brought to you in part by Kristen Daly Real Estate. Are you thinking about buying or selling your home this year and not sure where to start? Do you know what your property is worth? Kristen Daly and her team have been helping people purchase and sell homes for over 10 years. They can help you answer all these questions. Kristen and her team would be more than happy to help figure out the right move for you, help you navigate the process, and get you into the home that you've been looking for. Don't find yourself in the penalty box for using the wrong agent. Call Kristen at 781-264-6457 or find her online at kristendailyre.com. She looks forward to working with her, and if you contact her within the next 24 hours, she will provide a one-hour free staging consult with her interior designer. Hanover's on the ice. We're waiting for Bishop Stang. Doe won the draw, got it up for Meads. Meads in. Meads into the goal crease and a save by Hubert. Meads tried to end this game just 7 seconds into the extra period. They'll get another attacking zone draw and Doe to take it for the Indians. Doe won it. Out of the point. For McCabe. Doucette. Had to track it down. Here comes Bishop staying up the other way. Well wide. Kaminsky could not get a stick there in time. Hanover will look to break up the other end. It is Ernie Meads connecting with Tommy Martin. Tommy Martin trying to toe the line in the slot. Doucette could not get there in time for Hanover, but intercepted. It's Meads. Meads lost it to Foley, but battling now with Martin in the corner. But emerging is Kaminsky, who gets it up for Mendonca. Mendonca gains the line, fires, block a save, clap. Ho-hum for him. 5 minutes to go. Hassenfuss, co-captain of the Indians, in wide, shoots it. It was blocked. That was offside. Alex Swisness unable to keep his bearings. And we'll get a draw, 4:49 to go in overtime. Losing an edge was O'Neill, but he got it out of his zone, so he's okay. Hassenfuss gives chase. Can't get there. O'Neill right in front of us, battling with Swisness for the puck. Along the sideboards, Shane Fallon, cross ice over the stick of Tyler Powers, regains control. Diagonal pass. Morrissey couldn't connect with Wisness. Morrissey gets it though. Wisness rather, but it was intercepted. That is Morris for Wisness out to the near point for Fallon. Shane Fallon's going to let it fly. Save human rebound. Comes loose, and I believe that was Hassenfuss who couldn't backhand it home. Hassenfuss chips it onto the half glass. Morris in through the circle. And nobody was there at the point. This is going to be an icing, however, against Bishop Stang. Draw to come back to the Hanover attacking end with 3:55 to go in overtime. Doucette. Meads, McGlame, your forwards. McGlame back on D with McCabe. And Martin, the other forward, of course, for Hanover. 3:49 to go in overtime, number one. Back in his own end, it's McCabe. For McGlame. Martin couldn't get there. It was too long a pass. Chance Mendonca, too tentative to get there. The Hanover will have a chance, but it's intercepted by Scarbeck. Meads for Doucette. Doucette tries to jet up the right side, and it goes into the Bishop Stang bench. 3:10 to go in the extra session. The first of maybe two extra sessions preceding a shootout. Draw won by Bishop Stang. It's St. Martin who has it intercepted by Wisness. Wisnes. Couple of shift changes from Morris up for Hasenfuss. Hasenfuss into the left circle. Hasenfuss went wide of the net. Had a poke checked away, hoping Morris or Wisnes can get there. And it's Wisnes. Wisnes to the end boards off the skates of the official. Connects with Morris. Morris changes directions. Loose in that near corner. In the slot, Hasenfuss couldn't get there. Two on two they come. Bishop Singh gliding up ice. It's Peter Martin. Martin fires it well wide, but it's offside with 2:32 to go in overtime. Hasenfuss will take the draw for the Indians and won it against Kaminsky of Bishop Stang. Fallon for Powers. All the way up for Wisnes, who fires. It was blocked. A rebound shot. Again blocked. To the corner, it's Morris. Wisnes over to help him out. Being held up against that wall by a door. Here's Wisnes. Off the far half wall. In front for Morris, who's going to turn and fire. And it was blocked. 2:06 to go. Up the other way is Kaminsky for the Spartans. Mendoga backhands it off the end glass. We're inside 2 minutes to go. Next goal wins. One time bid saved by Clab off the stick of Mendoga. Far point at store. He already has one. Sent it towards the net. Went wide. Mendoga from the sideboards and the one time bid to Kaminsky. He fanned at the puck with 1:40 to go. Foley. It was going wide, but glove down by Clapp. One minute, 37 seconds to go in overtime number one. If it's not solved here, we will see a 6 minute, 4-on-4 overtime session. Meads trying to start a break up ice. Aided by the defenseman behind him. That was McGlynn. Fired by Martin. Save, rebound. And a great save by Hubert. Martin stays with the puck along the end boards. It's Martin. Martin on a tour of the attacking zone out to the far half wall to the point. Kept in barely by McGlynn. To Meads in the near corner. He's Hanover's goal scorer tonight with 1:08 to go. Here's Stang will try to clear. Cannot do so. Now they do. That's McCabe. Sends it into his attacking zone. McCabe fires it. Saved by Hubert. Doucette sends it along the end boards to the far corner for Martin. Martin still with the puck. Martin towards the slot. Nobody home. Doucette was in the wrong position. Doucette sent along the end boards. In out of the zone. Bishop Stang can't get a break with 35 seconds left. It's Hanover's puck. McCabe. Long pass for Doucette. Intercepted by St. Martin. But here's Hanover, back around. Teams changing deflections. Into the Hanover end. McCabe sends it right back out. 16 seconds to go. Up the far left. That was McGlynn. Here's Kaminsky with a chance. Kaminsky in the slot. Kaminsky, he shoots it wide. He had Clapp beaten, but he shot it too wide, and he knows it. Cade Kaminsky had the game in his hands. We are going to get a draw in the Hanover defensive end with 1 second left. Bishop Stang will aim to win the draw and shoot it. They pull Hubert for the 1 second. Really no risk here. They can't win the draw. And we're off to overtime number two, because why not? We've already seen one double overtime game today. Why not another? What a day of hockey yet again. We're going to take a very quick 30 or so second break. Catch our bearings. Don't go anywhere. MyHockeyLive.com. Well, 4-on-4 hockey it is. That is where an earlier game here between Marshall and Marshfield was decided. Can Hanover and Bishop Stang end it here in 4-on-4 double overtime? Or will we need a shootout? As Clapp sends it into the far corner with his blocker, as Bishop Stang controlled the opening draw. Pass and Foss was looking for the Hail Mary pass. Connected from Taylor. Taylor battling along the end boards. Has it picked off by Skarbek. Long passes out of the reach of Kaminsky, who almost won it with 10 seconds left in overtime number one. Long diagonal again intended for Hassenfuss. Can't get there. Gaining the line is Bishop Stang. Shane Fallon in his own end. 5:12 to go in the second extra frame. Five minutes left of double overtime. Hassenfuss up for Martin. Martin's going to let it rip. Save Hubert, a rebound, and it's wide of Hubert. Popped up, knocked down by Dor. Dor, your goal scorer for Bishop Stang. Ernie Meads for Hanover. Dor tees it up, and it is blocked by Doucette, who's slow to get up, and now he's hustling. He's a hockey player. 4.5 to go. Shane Fallon up through the middle. Gains the line up the right side, and they say he was offside. A glove save, nevertheless, for Hubert. Become all too easy for him. A chant of Hubert breaks out from his student section for the Bishop Stang goaltender. Taken back by McGlame, gains the line up the right side. McGlame into the corner. Looking towards a slack shot. Saved by Hubert. Absolutely denying Alex Wisnes. Can't get enough of this. The goaltenders are on another galaxy right now. Ryan Hubert and Noah Clapp putting on a display. That shot's taken and blocked. It is a shame that one team is going to have to lose this game eventually. But when? In double overtime or in the shootout? Here's chance for Hanover. Wisnes will lead the charge up with Meads. Wisnes gains the line up the right side. Advances the puck further. Meads will try to track it down at the near half wall. But it took a friendly bounce for Bishop Stang all the way out of the zone. That is Kaminsky. Narrowly missed ending the game in the first overtime. Lost it there. McCabe, the freshman, tracks it down. Over for Meads. Wisnes dumps it in. Hanover will change personnel. 3:15 to go in double overtime. Powers up for Hassenfuss. Hassenfuss, trailing pass for Martin. Save by Hubert, rebound. Hubert with another save. Ryan Hubert is having one of those out-of-body experiences right now. He is the best goaltender on the world in his mind right now. There's nothing he cannot do. Not to discredit Noah Clapp, but my goodness, Hubert in double overtime with perhaps his best save of the night. It's Kaminsky. Cade Kaminsky trails it from Mendonca, gives it back to Kaminsky. Kaminsky swiped away. 2:36 to go in double overtime. Crisp pass up for Hassenfuss. Lost an edge, gets back up, stays with the puck. Hassenfuss tried to flutter it over for Martin. Martin had a poke checked away by Foley. Up ice they come It's Menaka. Menaka fires, and that was blocked by Powers. Powers up through the middle, gains the line up the right side now. Powers in, taken down, no call by Dort. Powers gets back up. Allen up for McCarthy. McCarthy fires, saved by Clapp. Inside 2 minutes to go. McCarthy comes crashing into Clapp. McCarthy gives Clapp a little love tap. An acknowledgement of how bonkers this game is. 1:55 to go. Cameraman Art Egerton, he can't believe it. I can't believe it. Who can? Draw is won by Hanover. That's Meads. He scored seemingly last season. Really, it was in the second period. Teed up by Shane Fallon to the far corner. That is Wisness. Wisness for Fallon at the near point. Lets it fly right into the gut of Ryan Hubert. Seconds to go in the second overtime period. Pass and fuss on the draw. Aggressive win to Martin. Martin fires, saved by Hubert. Martin gets it back in the slot in for Hass and Fuss. Hubert dives on top of the puck to his right of the crease. What a fun hockey game. What a fun day of hockey here on MyHockeyLive.com. Hass and Fuss will try to win the draw to Martin. Martin does get it. Fires. Glove save. Hubert. The entire building is on its feet. Another Hubert chant breaks out from the Spartans crowd. Hass and Fuss couldn't win the draw, and it was set back towards Hubert by Scarbeck. A dangerous play, but what's getting past Hubert? Let's be real. Mendonca gains the line up the far side left. Off the end boards. Clapp is out of position. Kaminsky with the puck on the end boards. In the slot. Shot taken, and it goes through the crease. Scarbeck took the shot. Under a minute to go. Hass and Fuss is going to pick up the puck and loses an inch. The ice hasn't been done in a while, for what it's worth. It is St. Martin for Cade Kaminsky. Cade Kaminsky up the right side, gains the line and sends it into the corner, where he feeds it himself. Meads gets the puck for Hanover. Up the far right side of the ice, Mendonca gets in the way. And it's Wisness for Meads. Touch pass, gain in line. Wisness in the corner towards the slot. He couldn't connect with Powers. Jenny is fouled. Glove save, Hubert. I'm running out of superlatives. I ran out of them long ago. Ryan Hubert is playing the best game I've seen by a goaltender in a long, long, long time. In the slot, Wisness with 7 seconds to go. Kept alive by Martin. Teed around, saved by Hubert. 2 seconds to go. It's Bishop Stang puck. Of course we're going to the shootout. Minutes was not enough. Nor were 6 extra minutes, nor the 6 that followed that. 57 minutes of hockey. Not enough. We're going to a shootout. And we're going to take a break for the next 2.5 minutes to get ready for whatever ensues during this shootout. I can only imagine how this one's going to end. Do not go anywhere. MyHockeyLive.com. Welcome back. We're on to the shootout. 57 minutes of hockey, not enough. Cade Kaminsky to lead things off for Bishop Stang, who will shoot first. Kaminsky in to the slot, to the backhand. He goes, and it's a glove save by Ryan Clapp. Noah Clapp, I'm sorry. Was so busy saying the first name of Ryan Hubert. Got him confused with Noah Clapp, who, by the way, is having an outstanding game himself. Here's Landon Hassenfuss, a junior captain for Hanover. Hassenfuss takes this quickly into the slot to the backhand, score. Back to the forehand. Hassenfuss has solved Ryan Hubert. Tucker Mendonca, a senior defenseman, slash forward. Now for Bishop Stang. He starts out to his left and heads back to the slot. Mendonca is robbed by a Clapp with an outstanding glove save of his own. You may have forgotten how great a game Noah Clapp was having by how great Ryan Hubert was throughout overtime. But rest assured, he's been every bit as good as his Spartan counterpart. This will be Alex Wisnes now for Hanover. Wisnes through the middle, shoots, and saved by Hubert. Sent it away with a stick. Through two rounds of the shootout, it's Hanover 1, Bishop Stang 0. Each team will send 5 shooters. Here comes John St. Martin. Martin in, shoots, and it got by Clapp. But why? He made the initial save and let it trickle to the near side of the post. That will take us to Tommy Martin for Hanover. Tommy Martin, the senior forward, can give Hanover a commanding 2-0 lead in this shootout. Martin starts to his right and glides so elegantly back to the middle, and a pad save by Hubert. It's round 4, and here comes Mike Scarbeck, a junior for the Spartans. Scarbeck, again, right down the middle, rips it, beats Ryan Clapp. Noah Clapp, I got the name wrong again. Nevertheless, Bishop Stang with a goal to tie the shootout at 1-1. Here's Ernie Meads. Meads solved Hubert in the second period, the only Indian to do so in regulation tonight. Here he is again, shoots, and it goes off the post. He had Hubert beat, but it hit the post. So that will take us to Tristan Costa, a senior forward. If he scores here, he will give his team a 2-1 advantage in the shootout. Here comes Costa. Moves into the left circle. Costa into the slot, score! Bishop Stang has taken the lead. A save here could eliminate the Hanover Indians. It is all on the stick of Connor Morris, the freshman. Here's Morrison. He beat Tilbert. The freshman. The freshman. We are tied again at 2-2. It'll be Noah Knorr, who also scored for Bishop Stang in regulation. If Knorr scores here, his team wins. If not, we will go to a sixth round. And Knorr goes in the slot. Tries to go long, but Clapp makes the save. Took a bit too wide of a shooting angle. Well, of course, five rounds of a shootout wasn't enough. So here's Trevor Doucette, a junior for the Indians. He can give his team the lead back. Doucette in, right through the slot. Doucette in, save Hubert. That'll take us to Jack McCarthy. Again, McCarthy can win this for Bishop Singh. Clapp comes out of his crease, and it pays off. He makes the save on Jack McCarthy. We're on to round seven. It is Ryan Phillips now for Hanover. Ryan Phillips, a sophomore, will have a chance to give his team the lead. Phillips is in. Phillips scores. Hanover celebrating like they have won. But I believe, no, that's it. Hanover wins. Bishop Stang shot first. That's my mistake. That was the winning goal for Hanover. From Ryan Phillips. What a hockey game. The seventh round. And Ryan Phillips wins it for the Indians. Bishop Stang's Cinderella run comes to an end. But my almighty, they give the Hanover Indians all they could handle and then some. They almost won this game. Your three stars. Number three, Ryan Phillips. Did score the game winner in the shootout. Number two, Noah Clapp, the Hanover goaltender. But the number one star of the game is Ryan Hubert of Bishop Stang, the tough luck loser. And it feels wrong to call him the loser of this. But at the end of the day, the Hanover Indians move on in the Division III South. One of the greatest high school hockey games. One of the greatest goaltender duels that you will ever see. That's going to do it for us here at MyHockeyLive.com for today. I want to thank Art Egerton, behind video all three games this afternoon. Mark Igo, the CEO. Phil Garceau on some color commentary. I'm Jake Levin. We'll leave you with the teams exiting the ice. And tune in next time on MyHockeyLive.com. Thank you.